Hello everyone, today I am going to teach you about conductance of electrolytic solutions. It is necessary to define a few terms before we consider the subject of conductance of electricity through electrolytic solutions. The first important term is electrical resistance, R. It is measured in ohm with the help of Wheatstone bridge. Electrical resistance of any object is directly proportional to its length and inversely proportional to its area of cross section. That is, R is directly proportional to L by A. R is equal to rho L by A. Here, the constant rho is called resistivity. SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Resistivity of a substance is equal to its resistance when it is 1 meter long and its area of cross section is 1 meter square. Conductance G, the inverse of resistance R, is called conductance. G is equal to 1 by R, or G is equal to A by rho L. The SI unit of conductance is Siemen. Siemen is equal to ohm inverse. Conductivity K, the inverse of resistivity rho, is called conductivity. K is equal to 1 by rho. We can also represent conductivity in terms of conductance. Conductance G is equal to K into A by L. The SI unit of conductivity is S per meter. But quite often, conductivity K is expressed in S per centimeter. Conductivity of a material is equal to its conductance when it is 1 meter long and its area of cross section is equal to 1 meter square. Let's see the equation G equal to K into A by L. If here area of cross section is equal to 1 meter square, length of material is equal to 1 meter, what we can write? G is equal to K. That is, conductance equal to conductivity. So what is the definition of conductivity? Conductivity equal to conductance. Conductivity of a material is equal to its conductance when it is 1 meter long and its area of cross section is equal to 1 meter square. Classification of materials based on conductivity. Based on conductivity, materials are mainly classified into three types: conductors, insulators, and semiconductors. Conductors, materials having very large conductivity is called conductors. Metals, alloys, some non-metals like carbon black, graphite, and some organic polymers are examples of conductors. Insulators, materials having very low conductivity are generally called insulators. Example, glass and ceramic. Semiconductors, substances having intermediate conductivity between conductors and insulators are called semiconductors. Example, silicon, germanium, doped silicon, gallium arsenide, etc. Superconductors. What are superconductors? Superconductors have zero resistivity or infinite conductivity. Okay, that is, their conductivity is maximum. Example, metals and alloys at a very low temperature, 0 to 5 Kelvin, some ceramic materials and mixed oxides at a temperature 150 Kelvin are superconductors. metallic or electronic conductance. Electrical conductance through metals due to the movement of electrons is called metallic or electronic conductance. Electrolytic or ionic conductance. Electrical conductance through solutions due to the movement of ions is called electrolytic or ionic conductance. Let's see the other differences of metallic and ionic conductance. Metallic conductance is due to flow of electrons, so they are also called electronic conductance. Ionic conductance. In ionic conductance, conductance is due to movement of ions. Generally, ions are produced by electrolyte, so they are also called electrolytic conductance. Flow of electricity takes place without decomposition of the matter in the case of metallic conductance. But in the case of ionic conductance, flow of electricity leads to change in composition of electrolyte. Metallic conductance decreases with the increase of temperature, while ionic conductance increases with the increase of temperature. In metallic conductance, resistance is offered by metals is due to vibrating channels. But in ionic conductance, resistance is due to factors like inter-ionic attractions, viscosity of solvent, etc.